Howdy. Well, brethren, it's Christmas Eve, and we know that for the last few weeks, what all's been going on? Capitalism, commercialism. People have been storming the gates of different stores for toys, electronics, and to the dismay of many, many children, they've been obtaining socks. I hope everybody's been having a great time during the holiday season. I know that I have so far. You know, church, I was talking to my little sister, who's about 20, and I was talking about how she and I, we really don't get much presents anymore for this time of the year, and how we've begrudgingly just kind of come to grips with that reality over the last couple of years, and just thinking about, man, I'm getting to a point where I'm going to be able to share a lot of the stuff that I've been given with others, not expecting handouts from other people and gifts from other people. So that's why I'm really proud to announce that I've gotten socks for everyone at Kettering. Yay, happy holidays. No, I'm just kidding. I got you all yet another eTip for Christmas. That's right. It's another eTip coming right to your email this Tuesday, Christmas Eve. That's an evangelism tip for your encouragement so that you can be a brighter light for the cause of Jesus Christ in a cold and a dark world. And for this one, I want to help you guys with some gift ideas for the holidays. Most of y'all know where I'm going with this, and really I never claim to be subtle, but Jesus said in Matthew chapter 20 and verse 28 that he came not to be served, but to serve. What does that mean? That means he came to give of himself, even up to his very life for other people. We all have access to a lot of the same things that Jesus had to offer for others. Now, the main thing being salvation, but we all know it's not as simple as just plopping a Bible open and connecting some dots in the scriptures and just saying, here it is, what are you going to do about it? No, we've really got to embody the message and work with people. We got to minister to people. And there's spiritual treasure here at Kettering, ready to share. We have zeal, do we not? Zeal and passion for the Lord is the very beginning of every evangelistic effort. If people can see that you really do care about God, then some of them are just going to ask why. Some of them are going to want to know. So how do we give the gift of zeal? Well, we just talk to people about God, and we praise Him in our speech. We don't always need to just beat people over the head with doctrine right out of the jump. Sometimes it's better placed to just have a conversation magnifying God and bringing honor and glory to Him as He deserves. The majesty and grace of God is a wonderful starting point in any conversation. And with that, we have knowledge, another spiritual gift to be shared. After spending some time amongst you, brethren, I can tell you I've been floored by the amount of biblical knowledge that the brethren have here. So then how do we share our knowledge? Here's a tip. Just say these words. Would you like to study the Bible sometime? It's awesome. It's a harmless question. Almost nobody is going to freak out. And if they do, you probably don't need to be hanging around those kind of people. It's sort of unstable, right? You need to offer to share your knowledge. And with that knowledge, we have love. And love is what drives us to give of ourselves. Love and charity are synonymous in the Bible. When we have love for people, we absolutely will go out of our way to be a listening ear, a helping hand, and a warm heart for them. Just like Jesus was. Giving in this way and doing these things are going to give us opportunities to share our faith too. Salvation in Jesus is the gift that keeps on giving. So while everybody else is thinking about gifts this holiday season, I just thought it'd be good to remind you and the brethren here that you all have a lot of spiritual gifts that you can give. Things that have way more value than anything material. We shouldn't just sit on these spiritual blessings. They are meant to be shared. I also want to remind you that I have love for you, brethren, and I'm here for you. And that I hope that you and your family are blessed this season.